The Wizard's Spell. The sailing boat cut smoothly through the waters of the lake. Jamie sat in the stern, steering. Sarah, trailing one hand in the cool water, was looking ahead. Night was falling, and the stars were beginning to show.
There's a castle! Over there on the far side!
Watch out for those swans. If one of them gets angry, it can break your leg with just one blow of its wing. Steer around them, Jamie.
Okay. They look pretty peaceful to me, though.
What's that? Over near the swans.
I can't see.
It's a hand!
A what?
Jamie, there's a hand coming out of the water!
Help! Help!
There's someone in the water, they're drowning!
I see them! Mind your head on the sail!
Help!
Grab her hand, Sarah!
She's going under again!
Got you! Pull yourself in!
I can't!
Give me a hand, Jamie! We can do it between us!
Oh, thank goodness you turned up. This is always happening. Just look at me. I'm covered in pondweed.
What do you want to go swimming in your clothes for?
Shut up, Jamie. She must be freezing.
Oh, I'll soon dry off. That's not the problem.
So, what did happen?
It's that wizard Rothbart. He keeps changing me into a swan.
She's bonkers.
I tell you, it's true. As soon as night falls, I change back into a person and get soaked to the skin. I can't go on.
Maybe we can help you. Let's park the boat and you can tell us all about it.
You don't park a boat, you moor it.
A relief to feel dry land under my feet again. Come to that, it's a relief to have feet again. Last week, I changed back right in the middle of the lake and nearly drowned. I'm not the greatest swimmer.
So, who is this Wizard Rothbart? By the way, I'm Sarah and this is Jamie, my brother. He's not much of a swimmer either.
Thanks very much.
You may not believe this, but I am a princess. Princess Odette, and I am supposed to be going to a banquet at Prince Siegfried's castle tonight.
Is that it, on the other side of the lake?
That's right. You can just see the castle through the trees.
Yeah, looks quite a place.
Siggy and I have been in love for weeks. Wizard Rothbart got to hear about it, and that's when the trouble started. He wants poor Siggy to marry his own daughter, Odile, who's as ugly as a frog, so he can get his hands on the royal family's riches. He cast a spell on me, turning me into a swan by day to stop me seeing Siggy. Tonight, like I said, there's this banquet at the castle. Siggy's going to make our engagement public. Stupid old Rothbart isn't going to scare me off.
Not so stupid, my dear.
Rothbart! Don't let him near me, please!
You leave her alone!
Silence, you! So, my little Odette, you think I'm going to stand idly by while you trot off to the ball and claim your prince? Well, you're no Cinderella, my dear, and I'm certainly not your fairy godmother.
We can see that.
A little extra magic is called for. Maka Akas!
I don't believe it.
Look at her feet and her neck. She's turning...
A swan. That's right, girl. And you two meddling fools will make charming frogs. Maka Akaza!
Hey, what do you think you're doing, you big... Oh, no!
Jamie, that man-man's turned us into frogs!
The spell wears off at midnight. By then, it will be too late. My daughter Odile will be betrothed to Prince Siegfried, with the whole court as witnesses. Now, my two little friends, hop it.
This is the end! Siggy won't look twice at me like this.
I've got it! It's quite simple. All we have to do is get to the castle and delay the prince's announcement till after midnight when the spell wears off.
You're right. And a deck can give us a lift. I'm not hopping all the way.
I suppose it's worth a try. All right, hop aboard. That's it. Now, prepare for takeoff.
This is amazing.
There's a castle down there, all lit up like a Christmas tree.
I'll aim for that big tree by the castle window. Hold tight. We're coming into land.
Well done, Odette. A perfect touchdown.
Just hold still and we can climb up your neck onto the windowsill.
Keep still, we'll fall.
All right, Sarah. Now, one hop onto the windowsill. Made it.
I can see the prince, Odette.
What an outfit.
And no, it can't be.
What? What is it?
There's a beautiful girl standing next to him who looks exactly like you.
But without feathers and drier, of course.
Another of Rothbart's tricks. He's made his old bag of a daughter look exactly like me by magic. And a pile of makeup too, of course. Move over. I've got to see this for myself.
Watch out! You nearly knocked us off the ledge!
Oh, look at Siggy. Isn't he sweet? Oh, no. He's getting up to speak.
I say...
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for His Highness Prince Siegfried.
Oh, right. Thanks awfully. Actually, I just wanted to say, let the dancers begin. And that's all.
Phew. I thought he was going to start making his engagement speech. Look. He's trying to get his courage up by knocking back the wine. He's very nervous when it comes to making speeches. But I love him.
If we don't hurry, Odette, your prince is going to get engaged to the wrong girl. Come on, Jamie.
Come on where?
I bet the prince has a ring in his pocket. We're going to delay things a bit by stealing it.
Sounds good to me. Let's go, Sarah.
I'm right behind you.
This hopping's pretty good for getting around.
Yes, but everything's so big when you're a frog. Here, we can climb up these curtains onto the prince's table.
They're not curtains, that's a velvet dress.
Is it? Well, let's hope whoever's inside it doesn't notice. Made it onto the table at last. Right, there's the prince. Let's go.
Use these plates and glasses for cover.
If they spot us, we're frog's legs.
It's okay, everyone's watching the dancers.
You keep behind this bowl. I'll jump onto the prince's pocket.
I wish he'd hurry up.
There you go, Sarah. One ring. No problem at all.
Quick, we need somewhere to hide.
I know. Let's try the trifle.
Keep your head down. They'll never spot us in here.
Jolly good.
The prince is going to make another speech.
Ladies and gentlemen.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for His Highness Prince Siegfried.
They were quiet already, actually, Herald. Now, where was I? Ah, yes, the speech. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you from my bottom, or rather the bottom of my heart, for gracing our humble hearth. Oh, blow this. Look, the thing is, I have an important announcement to make, and, well, actually, this is the happiest day of my life. Aww. Princess Odette, darling.
Yes, my prince.
She sounds just like Odette as well.
Shh! Here comes the good bit.
I would like to present you with this ring. This... Wait a minute. It's here somewhere. This... Oh, no. Sorry. There's been a slight hitch. I know.
Let's have some music. Where's the ring, Harold? For pity's sake, get me a ring.
At once, Your Highness. A ring for Prince Siegfried.
Keep your voice down.
So far, so good, eh, Sarah? That should slow things down a bit. You know, this trifle isn't half bad. Try some.
I think I will. Cheers. You're right, Jamie. It's good.
Your Highness, I regret this is all that can be found.
Good grief! A brass curtain ring! Well, I suppose it'll have to do. Ahem!
My lords, ladies and gentlemen...
Oh, do shut up! Yes, well, as I was saying before, this is the happiest day of my life. Oh, that is, yes. Well, I mean, that is that I'm in love with, as it were, well, Princess Odette. And I want her, with her permission, of course.
He does go on, doesn't he? With any luck, he'll still be wittering on when midnight strikes. Oh, I wish I hadn't eaten so much of this trifle.
So I declare Princess Odette here will be my bride. And here is the curtain ring, engagement ring, with which I pledge my love.
Thank you, my prince.
Sarah, I think I'm going to be sick.
So is Odette.
No, I mean, really sick. It's all this trifle. I shouldn't have... Oh, that's better.
I say, what was that?
Well, it certainly wasn't me.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, there's something in the trifle.
Come on, Jamie, let's hop for it.
And the swan!
Look out, he's going for the princess!
Mind out for the swan!
There he goes!
It's up in the rafters!
It's got the princess's hair in its beak!
No, my dear, look!
It's a wig!
What's the wig?
The princess is as bald as an egg!
The spell's wearing off, Jamie. You look almost human again.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, look, up in the rafters there.
It's not a swan at all. There's a girl perched on the beam.
I am the real Princess Odette. And I've come to claim my prince before he gets himself hitched to Wizard Rothbart's daughter.
Wizard Rothbart's daughter? Is that who you are? You baldy?
Yes. It's true. I'm not Odette. My real name is Odile. It was all my father's idea.
Look, Jamie, she's crying. Her makeup's running down her face. She doesn't look anything like Odette anymore.
Especially with no hair.
Then you up there. You are my real princess.
Yes, my little Siggy.
Thank heavens. Come on, jump. I'll catch you.
Here I come.
Good catch, Siggy.
I've got a good idea. Let's all go for a stroll around Swan Lake in the moonlight while the servants clear up this horrible mess, not to mention the frogs. Oh, and guards, arrest Wizard Rothbart. Where is the blighter anyway, Harold?
Your Highness, my lords, ladies and gentlemen, Wizard Rothbart appears to have done a bunk.
Oh, well, no matter. I've got my Odette back and that's all that matters. Come on, darling.
Not too near the edge of the lake, Siggy darling, if that's all right with you.
Well, Jamie, looks like Odette got a prince, though we didn't get a chance to congratulate her.
It's certainly nice to be walking again instead of hopping. And you should have seen the fluff in the prince's pocket. Do you know that...
You meddling fools!
Oh, heck, it's Wizard Rothbart!
I will have my revenge!
And he's coming for us!
Run to the boat!
Made it! We'll be all right now, Sarah.
You reckon? Look back there!
Revenge! I will have revenge! Maha Akazi!
He's doing something to the lake. He's some kind of whirlpool. We're going in circles. Steer, Jamie, steer.
I can't hold the tiller. We're going down.
We're going down. Wait a minute. We're not going down. We're going up.
Are you right? And the lake, Swan Lake, it's all disappearing.
The music in The Wizard's Spell is from Swan Lake by Tchaikovsky. Scene of the Swans. The piece begins with a quietly rippling harp and an oboe playing a slow, spooky tune. It is nearly midnight and the moon is shining on the lake. Then the music gets louder as the rest of the orchestra joins in, with the brass playing the main tune. Waltz. This is introduced by gently plucked strings. But it soon gets noisier with kettle drums, cymbals, and brass joining in. Dance of the Little Swans. A bassoon plays a jumpy oompa accompaniment, while the oboe and flute play the main dance tune. The dance comes to a sudden end with two loud chords played by the whole orchestra. Dance of the Swan Queen. The scene is the lake, as at the beginning. A solo violin plays a sad melody. Odette, imprisoned as a swan, is dancing. Then the violin plays a faster tune. But the sad one soon comes back, played this time by the cello, with the violin and harp accompanying. Hungarian dance. The orchestra introduces this dance with a loud, slow fanfare. Then the strings and wind play a slow, winding melody. The dance gets faster and louder. The strings whirl, the cymbals clash, and the kettle drums boom. Finale. The last piece in the suite begins with violins and flutes playing a quick, tumbling tune. Bassoon, oboe, and then the strings play a slower melody, one after the other, which gradually gets louder. Right at the very end, the loud music fades away and only one instrument is left, the harp, which plays the final, quiet, rippling notes. Of course, these are just a few of the highlights of Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake Suite. You are sure to discover more every time you listen.